can see the column here, and that's separating the German part of the building from the prisoners' quarters. The wooden fence surrounding the building, the complex of building along here, there would have been a high barbed wire fence and patrolling guards, searchlights on the building, and so it's to understand that prisoners tried to break into the German part at first to leave from there. And even then, some tried, and the only one who had been killed in Colditz, he had his best performance somewhere here. That's him, Mike Sinclair, Scottish, nicknamed the Red Fox. He was very tall, one of the tallest, and Ginger stood out. His last try was end of September 1944. From the park, he ran, could get over the fence, did not stop off the warnings. The Germans shot at him to stop him, but from his elbow, the bullet ricocheted into his heart and killed him. It was a bad accident. And the Germans allowed the Brits to bury him with military honors in Colditz at first. Even the German security officer talked about him with admiration as the master of the escapes. And his best performance, he was the one that's very famous as well. Maybe you have heard about this. He impersonated one of the German guards, nicknamed Franz Josef because of the mustache. Was bald, so they shaved off his hair, made a mustache for him from his beard, cut the beard of another. And in the theater workshop, the prisoners, they could fake German uniforms very properly. This was easier than expected. The Dutch and Belgian ones had been produced in Germany before the war. Hugo Boss was the designer. Same fabric, same cut, just different color. MI9, you will find it in the museum then, the examples. They could smuggle in little capsules with liquid for dyeing fabric, with the instruction even how to get to the right color. And so in the theater workshop could dye these things and could make epaulets in bottles and such things. And then had proper German uniforms. And one day, Mike Sinclair, dressed up as him, together with two forged guards, left the sick bay where the idea was born. They came from around the corner along here to send a permanent guard somewhere here back to the guardhouse. And then 30 British prisoners were waiting behind one of these windows for roping down and faking a walk to the sports ground, the other end of the town. That happened sometimes, and escorted by Franz Josef, even better. He was famous for being arrogant, not talking to people, perfect. But the devil is in the detail always. He was limping and along the park had a habit. In a special sequence of steps, he always stopped, looked down to the park, stopped, looked down to the park and further on. And Mike Sinclair forgot two times to do this. And the guards watching them from somewhere else, they said, something's definitely wrong today. Wrong patrol time, they came between two German patrols, not the right way of walking, and so they run to the guardhouse, and then I would give 10 minutes of my life to see the real situation. The two of them, the real one and the fake one, were standing face to face. Mike Sinclair must have been first class. Another German guard entering the scene related from the other direction, from a distance could not make the difference. And at last, some from the German, there was some shouting, shoot him down, and he shot at last and hit Mike Sinclair, but he survived this time. Bullet was going through the shoulder. And that's why we don't have a photograph of both of them. He needed medical aid then. But it's fantastic try, isn't it?
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and share it with your friends. You can also visit www.discerninghistory.com for more videos and other resources.